You have said one quote that seek light, see light and then be light. I was reading the Krishnamurti's book. There was one line that seeking is a kind of self-expansion and it's an escape and you cannot get freedom out of it. So I was confused.
When Krishnamurti is saying seeking is an extension of self-centered activity, he is talking of the stuff that you usually seek. Krishnamurti is not talking to those who seek light. People seek darkness and its various shades. Here are the people, and they are seeking darkness in its various hues and shades. Krishnamurti's way is to tell them don't seek. My way is to tell them seek light. Because people are usually seeking only darkness. So Krishnamurti comes and tells them don't seek. What he means is don't seek darkness. I come and say seek light. Why do I say seek light? Because I know that seeking is a habit with you. If I just keep saying don't seek, that would not fulfill you. Because in your deepest identity, you have taken yourself as incomplete. If you are incomplete in your own eyes, then you will seek. You cannot be prevented or banished from seeking. No amount of good advice is going to work. In fact, it would be a disaster if you remain inwardly incomplete and yet put on a pretense of not seeking. That is called tamsa. Inwardly, you take yourself, you continue to take yourself as incomplete, and outwardly, you follow the commandment of not seeking. Now, not only are you incomplete, your incompleteness will become cemented. It will become immortal. Do you see this? You are incomplete within, and yet it has become a thing of fashion with you to say, oh, I do not seek anything, I do not want anything. So you do not change. You do not seek anything, you do not want anything, so there is no change. So what does not change? The incompleteness within. It becomes permanent. I say, you will not stop seeking. Seeking will continue. It is your most fundamental restlessness that seeks. You will seek. I cannot prevent you from seeking. And if you don't seek, you will become a hypocrite. So I just channelize your seeking. I say seek light. I do not say don't seek. I say seek light. But obviously all of that must be done with a lot of caution. With a great inclination towards darkness, if you start seeking light, then your so-called light will just be an extension of darkness. And Krishnamurti has repeatedly emphasized on this. He says, if you seek light, it would be just another form of darkness. And he's right on the money. What he's saying is exact and precise. But such is the human condition. On one hand, there is a great danger that if you seek light, you will seek the wrong kind of light. You will just seek darkness disguised as light. On the other hand, there is the equally dark option of not seeking at all, Between these two possibilities, I prefer the possibility of seeking light with all its associated dangers. There are a lot of dangers associated with seeking light because the ego does not like light. It will seek some false kind of light. But that is still better than not seeking at all. Isn't it better to die fighting in the battle than not fight at all?